My name is Gladys Kalichini. I'm doing my third year of PhD in art history with the Department of Fine Arts. My thesis is provisionally titled Invisible Freedom Fighters, a critical analysis of portrayals of women freedom fighters in Northern Rhodesia, Southern Rhodesia in archival photographs and the contemporary arts. This is the arts lounge and I'm going to be taking you through the space. When you come in, we've got like chalk walls. The drawings that you see on them right now were drawn by Walen Mapondera, who's a former master's student here. This is a painting that was donated by Pejulai Wola, who's a Nigerian artist, and she did her residency here. And you keep coming. This is Perpetua's office. And she sort of facilitates or communicates between the students and our supervisor, and you can print and photocopy from over there. And there's a couple of books, library, that students can borrow out and read, but more preferably to read it here. Come in here. And come in here, you've got the dining kitchen area. So sometimes we sit here to do Pomodoros or when you're having writing sessions or to meet a couple of times when the students are socializing. They can cook together over there and then eat over here. The cabinet library is some African arts journals. Prof. Simbao edits some of these journals and some of them is theses by students here, so which help as an example for students when they come, they can read the proposals and the theses to see what sort of writing is like. This is the PhD room. They are also free to sit outside and write from outside on one of the benches. All the computers here are equipped with internet, which is the Rhodes Wi-Fi. This first started off as the room for master's students only, but then now because we've got a couple more PhDs, there's some PhDs that can sit here and some sit over there, but students are pretty much free to sit where they sit, but they have an assigned computer. This is the lounge area. We sit in here too when we're having meetings or when we're having seminars or when students are practicing for a presentation, either for the department or for a conference that they're taking part in. The place is quite interactive. We have a wall here, which we call a good read. So each student comes and you write whatever book you're reading at the moment in there. When you come on this way, you've got a couple of posters from previous events that we've had. We've got Walen Mapondera, Tando Mama, who had a talk. You've got Irshan Adam and Zimbali Koza, who had a talk. You've got Professor Pejulai Wola, who also did a residency here and had a talk, and with Dr. Patrick Oloko, who also did a writing residency for their talk over there. Then when you come in here, this space kind of like doubles as two spaces. It's Professor Simbao's office, but at times also it's used for when we're having some meetings or when we're doing like writings, or if it's a smaller workshop, like if it's the workshop, for example, that's just for PhDs or PhDs are working on just writing, then you can use this space. I would rate the PhD program at Rhodes University 9 out of 10, because I think it's a very good place to write your PhD from or to do your PhD from, because it's sort of isolated, so it gives you some nice time to be able to concentrate on your work and there's enough resources and support. And the reason I didn't give it a 10 is because I'm doing a PhD in art history and I would really appreciate if there was like a lot of galleries around, which is something I don't think is really the problem of the university. It's because it's a small town.